Hello children, good morning. We'll start with a new chapter, lesson 10. India Agriculture. By the name you can understand we will be talking about agriculture in India. Now since ancient time, agriculture has remained a prime economic activity of most of the people in India. We are talking about ancient period. That time also it was a prime economic activity. That means most of the people were engaged in agriculture. They were agriculturists. Even today, for main support for Indian economy is agriculture. It's a very important resource of India. 60% of the labor power is engaged in agriculture. Besides supplying food to the people of India, raw material for many industries also comes from agriculture. This we have done in your previous chapter, that raw material which comes from agriculture. That means industries are based on raw material getting from the agricultural field. Agriculture occupies about 22% of the national product. Please, when I am explaining you all, you have to look into your book and pay attention what I am speaking. Afterwards, you have to read the lesson twice. The answers will be seen marked. You have to note down them in your notebooks. Crops and other farm products also hold 18% contribution in exports. You have to remember this. 60% labor power, 22% national product, and 18% contribution in export, which is getting, we are getting foreign exchange because of export. The Indian economy is mainly dependent on agriculture. That is why India is called as agrarian country. In most of our areas in India, two or more crops annually can be taken due to the factors like fertile plains, favorable climate for round the year, irrigation, skilled and hardworking farmers, etc. See, we are getting these facilities. Which facilities? That why we are having this cultivation round the year? Because which facilities we are having? Irrigation, we have skilled and hardworking farmers. The important factor is fertile plain and favorable climate. So even then, the progress in the field of agriculture is not sufficient. Still, we need more. The Indian farmers are generally poor and uneducated. Agriculture production in India is much less compared to the world due to the reasons like inadequate facilities of irrigation, irregular and uncertainty of rain, more population, larger families, smaller farms, no interest in experimentation, less usage of chemical fertilizers, modern machineries and scientific approach for cultivation, education mass opting away from agriculture, and so the lower status for agriculture is in the society. Now again, I'll explain you, in most of the areas, two crops are annually can be taken. It can be done. Because we have fertile plains also favorable, as I told you in the beginning when I was started explaining you. But since these problems are also faced by us, that is not much facilities of irrigation, uncertainty of rain, population is more, families are large, farms are small, they are not having interest for going for experimentation, the usage of chemical fertilizer is less, modern machineries and approach to these things like modern machinery and scientific approach is also less, and the mass which is educated, they are getting away from agriculture. They think that in agriculture they are not going to get much, so they are getting away from it. It's so the society, it's a lower status in the society, so they are getting away from it. But actually it is not like that. Compared to world, we can be at a better place, but still we are not. Now we have different types of farming. We one by one we will go through it. Subsistence farming. After independence, many development projects have been implemented, and though the farmers are little weak today, economic condition, because they are not able to purchase, they are poor, that is why costly seeds, fertilizers, pesticides are not affordable by them, and their farming is also they are holding a small farm. The farm production is just sufficient for their family, so extra production is not there in their farm, only for their family. They are maintaining their family by cultivating their farm only. This is called subsistence farming. So Indian agriculture is considered to be activity for life maintenance only. So which is called as life maintenance farming, that is subsistence farming. Next comes dry farming, where the rainfall is inadequate, that means less. So irrigation facilities are less there. Farming is dependent only on rain. Only one crop is taken through the humidity accumulated within the land. साल में दो crops grow कर सकते हैं, लेकिन वो एक ही crop grow करते हैं. This is known as dry farming. Crops like jowar, millet and pulses which requires less water are grown here. In Gujarat, wheat and gram are grown in humid soils after the monsoon is over. Wet farming, here there is heavy rain, with the name you can understand, and inadequate facilities for irrigation. Facilities are not much of irrigation. There is no rainfall, or if it is insufficient, more than one crop is taken with the help of irrigation within paddy, sugarcane, cotton, wheat and vegetables are grown here. Shifting, zoom. What they do in zoom, the forest are burned and cleared and farming is carried out there. The farming takes only for 2 to 3 years and then the fertility of the soil is reduced and that area is being left as it is. This is called zoom farming. Cereals or vegetables are grown in this type of zoom cultivation, zoom agriculture, cereals and vegetables are grown. And in this, the production is less. Then plantation agriculture. This is a special type of agriculture. Here, see, rubber, tea, coffee, cocoa, coconut, apple, mango, orange, grapes, amla, lemon. All these are being grown. And here, they are having a more capital investment. They need skill, technical knowledge, machines, fertilizers, protection on all sides, and transportation facilities. Next comes the intensive farming. In this, the mechanized way of farming through utilization of increased irrigation, use of chemical fertilizers, insecticides and other mechanical equipment. So all the modern facilities have to be available for intensive farming. Yet the cash crops are grown in this type of farming. The per hectare production has increased very much here and are sown under these crops have been increased as more importance is given to the economic returns. See, whatever is being produced, they need the returns of it. That is why it is also called as cash crops. Yani ki turant aapko iske badle mein paise mil sakte hain. So it is also known as commercial farming. Now there are different types of farming method. Now we have organic, sustainable and mixed farming. So first one is organic. Here the rate of chemical fertilizers and the insecticides are used. The destructive effect of these chemicals is also felt. Organic farming, the rate at which the chemical fertilizers are being used, the insecticides are being used. With that, what happens? The destructive effects of these chemicals are seen. And because of this, this is 2.1 answer. If you can see minutely, you will be able to see that answer is being marked. So due to this presence of these chemicals and insecticides, what happens in grains and vegetables and fruits? They are adversely affected related to the hygiene of the people. Damage is caused to the environment. The capacity and fertility of the land is also getting reduced, due to which the crop production of land and its quality is reduced in the long run. Instantly you are getting the results by using the insecticides and fertilizers. So this method, which organic method, is that method in which they are not using chemical fertilizers and insecticides. In place of that, the urea is being used. And for the nutrition, for better fertilizer, as fertilizer if you talk about it, it's crop dung, earthworm fertilizers, then composite fertilizer, etc. are used. Cow urine, neem solvents, buttermilk, this is used for as a fertilizers. The organic products are full of nutrition. They contain natural taste, sweetness and fragrance. There are minerals, vitamins and life energizing elements in those crops. Nowadays, organic farm products are more in demand, so the farmers are also getting a good return. Next comes sustainable. In order to see the soil fertility is retained for a long time, care is being taken for crop rotation. See, sustain means soil fertility has to be retained. So use of chemical fertilizers only when it is necessary. Use of biotic control for insects and harvest water conservation is done in sustainable farming. Then comes mixed farming. Here mixed farming means sub mixed karke. Cattle rearing, poultry, sericulture, fishery are also carried out simultaneously along with farming. Now as per the seasons, the agriculture products of India, if you see this box blue color, there are kharif crop, monsoon crops, which are generally during, crops are grown during rainy season. The months are given here: June, July, October, November, and the names of the crops. Rabi means winter crop. Now we will be having winter crop October till March or April. Then comes Zaid, that is summer crop, and how, when it is grown, from which month to month. This you have to note down in your notebook. This is your 2.2 answer. Next comes the major agricultural crops. Turn to page 78. Now here the names are given. This also you have to write down in your notebooks as it is. Food, pulses, oil seeds, beverages, just for your knowledge. Next comes the food grains. Grains are cultivated about 75% of the total area sown, and about 50% of the total productions come from grains. Now which are those grains, we will be going through one by one. The first one is paddy. Paddy means what? Rice, that is. Paddy is one of the most important crop. A large majority of the world and about half of the population of India uses rice. India stands second in the world after China. India stands second. This is your 2.4 answer. If you see, it has been marked. Paddy is sown over 1/4 of the total sown area. जो टोटल एग्रीकल्चरल लैंड है उसमें से 1/4 इज बीन यूज्ड फॉर पैडी. पैडी इज अ क्रॉप ऑफ टॉरिड जोन. हॉट एंड ह्यूमिड क्लाइमेट, मिनिमम टेम्परेचर ऑफ 20 डिग्री सेल्सियस, फर्टाइल एल्यूवियल सॉइल एंड मोर देन 100 सेंटीमीटर ऑफ रेनफॉल. इट रिक्वायर्स अ गुड इनफ ऑफ रेनफॉल. इन द रीजन ऑफ रेनफॉल इन पंजाब, हरियाणा, उत्तर प्रदेश, दिस क्रॉप्स आर टेकन थ्रू इरीगेशन. More human labor is necessary for paddy. These are the states: West Bengal, Tamil Nadu, Andhra Pradesh, Telangana, Bihar, Orissa are major paddy producing states. The crop is taken 2 or 3 times in West Bengal, Uttar Pradesh, Bihar, Orissa and Tamil Nadu. In Gujarat also it is being grown in Tapi, Surat, Panchmahal, Ahmedabad, Kheda, Anand, Valsad districts. Paddy is a crop which requires more water. Instead of keeping the paddy field fully under water, paddy is grown by irrigating through sprinklers using less water. Next comes wheat. Now wheat is the second important crop after paddy. Wheat is grown over 1/3 area of the arable land of our country. It is sustainable food of the people living in North and West India. It's a temperate zone crop, rabi. It requires black and fertile loamy soil, more than 75% of annual rainfall, and wheat has been grown in the region of lesser rainfall with irrigation. If rainfall is less, but they are making use of irrigation facility. Wheat cannot be grown in the area where the rainfall is more than 100. Okay, there the more here what we have seen, 100 centimeter of rainfall in paddy, but here the wheat cannot be grown if it is more than 100 centimeter. Less labor force is required as mechanization is introduced in wheat cultivation. They are using mechanized machines. After a green revolution, the wheat production is almost double. Wheat cultivation is carried out in Punjab, Haryana, Uttar Pradesh, and these states are contributing 2/3 of the total national production because they have good facilities. And state, there is more per hectare production due to canal water in Punjab. There is abundant wheat production. Punjab is famous for wheat. The Punjab is also called as wheat bowl of India. Wheat is also produced in the states of Madhya Pradesh, Rajasthan, Gujarat, Maharashtra and West Bengal. Underline this, Bhalia wheat is produced in the Bhal region of Gujarat. This is your 3.3 answer. Besides Mehsana, Rajkot, Junagadh, Kheda also produce wheat. Among all the food grains of daily meals, wheat is the best. Many items like rotli, bhakri, sev, siro, lapsi, ladu, sukhadi, bread, puri, cake, biscuits are prepared, isn't it? So among all grains, wheat is most nutritious. That is why it is called as the king of grains. Why it is called as king of grains? Because it is daily we are using it, and so many things are being produced, and it is said to be very nutritious. Now we'll continue with our next part. Just you have to go through this map where the wheat is being produced and where the paddy is being produced. Paddy and Gehun. Okay, so this is your agricultural crop. You just have to note down what which are the places, and we will continue with our next part in part 2. Thank you.